HX50 is a very big 5-seat helicopter with lots of glazing, so you get an amazing view, a nice big door, so entry and egress is simple for everybody. The downside of that, of course, is that the glazing and the doors themselves represent quite a significant proportion of the empty structural weight of the aircraft. And so during the development of the Gen 2 fuselage, we've expended a lot of effort getting the structural weight of the doors for both the front, the back, and the cargo doors down to the absolute minimum with a really, really efficient structural recipe. So to do that, what we've done is we've used the glazing panels on the exterior of the door as part of the structural elements of the door to give it its stiffness and its structural integrity that it needs. By doing that, we've been able to avoid the need for structural cores in the center of the door because we now no longer have to tool the opposite side of the closed sections. And on top of that, we've now fully integrated the strip lights and the latest version of the internal and external door handles, along with the central locking and all of the electrical stuff that goes in there to power that. With all of those things packaged and the new door layout completed, we've also now started optimizing the laminate detail of the door that brings in all of the structural optimization we need, as well as the elements of the composite design that we need to be able to produce a really high quality paint finish simply and efficiently in production. To make the sheer volume of helicopters and indeed doors that we have to make, we need a really efficient methodology for manufacturing molds and the patterns from which we take the molds. Now, carbon parts work best when you manufacture them from carbon molds. So what we've got here is a pattern for the carbon mold that we'll then make the carbon door skins from. Now, this encompasses a lot of the research and development that we've conducted over the last 2 years, 18 months or so, where we've extracted a lot of the techniques from large composite structures, such as boat building, and fused those with the level of integrity and production quality that we need for aerospace applications. So what you can see in front of us here is essentially a production intent pattern for one of the forward passenger side doors. So you'll see that the tool is now mounted on a rigid base that's readily stackable, because once these are used to produce the individual molds, these get stored for relatively long periods of time before they're needed again. So it's important that we can stack them out in the storage areas. The tool now uses a vacuum type base seal on top of the baseboard. So we hold vacuum integrity all the way through the core of the tool. This uses a fiberglass layer to seal in the vacuum layer. And then we've got a base layer of low cost polystyrene, which we then cover with a fiberglass layer to give it some structural integrity. As with some of the previous molds that you've seen us make, what we've got then is a new approach to pasting. So we've pasted the tool as we did previously, but we've got an all new approach to pasting, which uses an epoxy-based tooling paste delivered by an improved paste application machine that we've invested in over the course of the last 6 months or so. Once we've applied the paste, it then goes on to the new gantry mill, which of course is capable of machining 24/7 lights out and to far tighter tolerances than we've ever been able to previously. So what that means is the tool, when it comes straight off the mill, is almost ready to mold off directly. It needs very, very minimal hand finishing and then just sealing, and it's ready to take the carbon tools off it, ready to produce the door skins. So all of this means that we're now able to make composite parts at a lower cost and to a higher quality with a better surface finish, ready for paint, faster and more reliably than ever before. So with the cost-effective tooling approaches nailed, and we're now in a position to make the composite tools at the scale we need to make the volume of parts that we need to, the next area that the guys have been focusing on has been getting the laminate right for the non-structural panels. So these are panels that don't really carry structural loads in the airframe, but they have large surface area. So getting the weight down to the minimum and getting the quality of the composite to the highest standard to make it as easy as possible to paint, even when it includes things like lightning strike protection and various other bits and pieces that we have to include in there to get the performance and the durability that we want. So we've got the laminate recipe sorted now for both non-structural and the structural components. The laminate material qualification work is ongoing at the moment to give us the structural properties we need for the approvals process. And then in parallel with these activities, we've been working with our production paint suppliers to optimize the paint process and the paint recipe that we're going to use in production to get the weight of paint on the aircraft down, which is actually really significant, and to get the surface finish that we're able to deliver straight out of the gun to the highest possible level so that we need the least amount of post-production and polishing once we've got these panels painted. All of these things need to be taken into account far earlier than you probably think they do, because they all have a bearing on the weight, they all have a bearing on the recipe that you use for the materials that you then subsequently have to qualify. So we've been looking at some of the standard colours, the graphite grey, and we did a cheeky red one for Mike Holt and Peter Wilson. And then the guys have also been playing around with some of the effects that you can use as part of more adventurous paint schemes. And all of these things have come out very nicely. We've got the basic paint finish and process down to where we want it to be. And we're just about to produce a bunch of paint trial panels that are going to go out and start being environmentally tested to make sure that we don't have any cracking, peeling, degradation or print through happening when those panels are out there in pretty extreme climates for long periods of time.